Our next caller is our friend Manu.
Hey, Manu.
Manu, welcome to our program.
Hi, good evening.
What's up,
good
friend? Evening. How you doing?
Good, thank you. You started the show by about the name of Jesus, and I was excited because that was the point that I was contemplating today making comments about.
Yes, get us back on track, Manu.
Yes, we want to go back to Jesus, Islam Christian perspective. So go ahead, friend.
Yes. You mentioned the book of Isaiah 9.
Yes.
And about the and you brought those verses to show the name Prince of Peace,
precisely,
Mighty
yes.
God, Eternal Father, all those.
Mm-hmm.
What I was thinking about today was that actually the name of Jesus was not given by Mary or anybody else. It was given in Luke. It says that the name of Jesus was delivered to Mary,
mm-hmm.
and it wasn't of original. It wasn't originated on earth. Nobody gave him that name. The angel said that you will call this child this name, Jesus.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Also, Quran itself says that. The
okay.
Quran says that the name that Jesus is given is from God.
And it's a different name in the Quran
but
than in the Kitab al-Muqaddas.
Yeah, let me make this point before we go to Isa and Yeshua.
Yeah.
We'll talk about it.
Okay.
I just want to see where he's getting to.
So, I believe there's a connection between the name Yeshua and Yahweh.
Yes, there is.
If I'm not mistaken.
Sure. Yes.
And that really ties into the prophecy of Isaiah, which Quran calls the Yasa. The name Yasa is actually Isaiah.
Okay.
And the verses that it in Isaiah 9, 20 or 9:6 onward.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
So if we see that, it says that his name will be called all those names.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. It doesn't indicate anything about divinity of Jesus. As far as I can see, it just shows his name will be called synonymous with Yeshua, which is very close to Yahweh.
Only
now,
problem
tell
with
me
that.
Where am I in error?
Okay, you're in error because you didn't finish Matthew 1:21. The very passage that you're referring to, Matthew chapter 1, verse 21, the angel tells Joseph, she will give birth to a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, and then he explains why. The very next sentence explains why. Because he will save his people from their sins. The reason why Jesus is given the name Yeshua, because Yeshua is an abbreviated form of Yehoshua, which means Yahweh is salvation. So the angel says, the reason why you are to call him Yahweh is salvation, because he is the Savior who does what the Old Testament says Yahweh does, save his people from their sins. So actually, if you're going to argue from the New Testament, the very name of Jesus indicates that in his case, and I want to emphasize that, the reason why he's given that name is to indicate his function and nature as God who saves. That's Matthew 1:21. You read it. If you have your Bible, open it up.
Yeah.
She will give birth to a son, and you will call his name Yeshua, because, and he gives the reason for the name, he will save his people from their sins. Now, Manu, if you cross-reference that with Psalm 130, and you read verses 7 to 8, do you have a Bible with you, Manu?
Yes, I have.
Okay, turn to Psalm 130, verses 7 to 8. According to the Old Testament, who saves Israel, his people, from their sins? Psalm 130, verses 7 to 8. O Israel, put your hope in Yahweh. When you see the word Lord, all capitals, that's Yahweh. For with Yahweh is unfailing love, and with him is full redemption. He himself will redeem Israel from all their sins. Yahweh is the one who saves his people from their sins. But the angel says, Jesus is called Jesus because he comes to save his people from their sins, which according to the Old Testament is something that God does. So do you believe that?
Manu, I just want to add one more thing before you answer. Manu, if you look back at the passage that Sam and you were quoting there in Matthew chapter 1, when it says that the name of Jesus, it should be called Jesus. She will bring forth a son, they shall call his name Jesus, Matthew 1, verse 21. And then it says, the very next verse, look at verse 22. Now all this was done Now, that refers to everything before that and what immediately precedes that. Now, all this was done was that the naming of this child would be Jesus. And Sam is pointing out that this Jesus, it means Yahweh saved.
In fact,
right?
If you continue to see, you're going to see that Matthew identifies Jesus as God with us.
Well, that's what I'm going to.
Yeah.
So, verse 22. Now, all this was done that, why? That it may be fulfilled, which was spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying, Behold, a virgin shall be with child, and shall bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which being interpreted is God with us. So understand, Manu, that this Jesus, that it was done so that it might be fulfilled, because calling him Jesus in this case, the understanding is, yes, his name was Jesus. But his name wasn't Emmanuel in the sense that, oh, everybody called him Emmanuel, but he was known as Emmanuel because he's God with us. And then these same titles that you referred to in Isaiah 9, 6, and 7, this isn't his specific name. People didn't go down the street when Jesus was there and just say, hey, there's Mr. Wonderful, or there's Mr. Counselor. These were actually descriptions of who this person was. The Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace, God with us, and you'll find that testimony throughout the New Testament.
Manuel, we don't want to overwhelm you because we do want you to interact, but let me further confirm that as far as Matthew's concerned, now you may reject Matthew, that's okay, and we'll talk about the evidence why you should accept Matthew, but he just said, if you continue reading from 21:23, two things happen. Jesus is called Jesus to indicate his nature and function. He's Yeshua because he's the one who comes to save his people from their sins. By being born of the Virgin, he's Emmanuel, meaning God with us. That Matthew is presenting Jesus as God who has come to live with us. You don't need to stretch things or go to commentaries. You read Matthew himself. Matthew ends his gospel the way he starts it. In Matthew 28:20, Jesus, quoting Jesus, he ends the gospel the way he starts it. Notice how he started it? Jesus' birth means that Emmanuel has come. God is now with us because Jesus is Yahweh who comes to save his people. Matthew 28:20. And teaching them, this is Jesus speaking, to obey everything I have commanded you, and surely I, Jesus is speaking, am with all of you, always, till the very end of the age. Jesus is saying, I will remain with all of you till the end of the age. Well, the only way Jesus can say he can be with all the believers at the same time, no matter where they're at, is if Jesus is omnipresent. But to be omnipresent, you must be God, because only God sees everything and superintends everything, so that no matter where you're at, God is there, he sees you, and he'll protect you if you belong to him. So Matthew begins with Jesus being Yahweh who saves, God who is with us, and he ends the gospel the same way. Jesus remains the God who is with his people till the end of the age. So if you're going to go by the gospels, you're going to have to accept the fact that the gospels present Jesus as the human appearance, human manifestation of the God of Israel.